Bridges are a key element of the transportation infrastructure. In the time since our existing bridges were built and designed, the forces brought to bear on them have changed considerably. Especially heavy goods traffic has increased, and that is exactly what damages the bridges over time. And when recalculating our old bridges today using new rules of the trade, we occasionally discover significant computational deficits in many structures. We assume, however, that a number of these structures have reserves, and our aim now is to explain the load-bearing behavior as realistically as possible in order to improve the accuracy of our existing models a bit. If we succeed, we will be able to preserve a series of structures even longer without lessening the required safety. To improve our models, we are currently doing extensive laboratory tests. To this end, we have developed a completely new test bed. Here we can apply loads comparable to those in a real bridge. Using these large metal plates with the ribs, we impart loads precisely and can model the area around a pillar, exactly the area that interests us. This allows us to very effectively run many tests and systematically investigate the effects, which would not be possible on a large bridge. We are currently calibrating this small test bed to try to reconcile it with actual structures. In other words, we are looking to see whether real structures behave exactly as the laboratory tests indicate. And that was the truly unique opportunity that we had in the city of Hammelburg. What we were looking for was a continuous bridge that extends across multiple supports and between the individual supports, what we refer to as a span. In other words, a multi-span bridge. Because there we have the chance to do tests on multiple spans next to multiple pillars. There have been no tests done anywhere in the world that lead to the point of failure. In other words, where you try to look at the behavior when approaching the load capacity limit. Since we wanted to test the Hammelburg bridge in several individual spans, we had to design a test rig that could be moved from one position to another. And we came up with a construction consisting of a main girder. This beam serves as a buttress for hydraulic cylinders, hydraulic presses that we load the bridge with. All in all, our cylinders had a peak performance of about 14 meganewtons. That's 1,400 tons, about 1,000 cars. Of course, a lot of work had to be done. First, the measuring technology had to be installed. We have a fiber optic strain measurement system, which is a novel measuring system that has never been deployed on this scale for experiments outside the laboratory. In other words, in a real-life structure. In addition, we had the chair of geodesy as our partner. With their cameras, they recorded the cracks produced and the size of those cracks. There was also an external company on site that cut the bridge into three sections, so that we had three separate elements of the bridge in the longitudinal direction. We did this to ensure that the bridge on site would be comparable to the experiments carried out to that point, and also with our laboratory tests. In a real structure, it is not easy to produce this shear force failure intentionally, but we succeeded in all five spans. We had shear cracks in each of the five cases, and that is exactly what we were after. Of course, we gathered extensive test results and measurement data on this structure, and the first preliminary evaluated results indicate that the laboratory tests depict reality quite well. On the other hand, we see that the reserves anticipated in our models are likely to be confirmed, and these can be used for improved models that will preserve existing bridges longer.